still play day, A-Pay. Before I craft a spot, stay at home a lot. Cause when I run the plots that I'm known to concoct, can hear the screams of fools when I fall them rocks. Elven ladies, they pay homage, but play and say, hey fellow, how? My last game was supersonic. How they wondering if I still got it? They say the game's changed, they wanna know what I think about it.
If you ain't rolling dice,
Game Master A is the name and I'm running this game. Still reading the splat, still planning attacks, still not wanting your crap. Still rock my crew, we're the bard and the thief.
Hello, and welcome to the next episode. The next episode of THACA, or 2-Hit Armor Class Awesome. With your host, me. Now, the next thing that this episode is about is mostly about classes that are chosen at the beginning of a Dungeons & Dragons game. And I'm going to talk about in particular ones that I think get a bad reputation, man. So you got your gaming group together, right? And there's like the guy who's like, I'm gonna be a fighter, cause I like hitting shit and fucking shit up. You got the other guy who's like, I'm gonna be a wizard, cause I'm gonna play the long-term game and be able to throw fireballs and raise the dead or some whatever the fuck school he does end up going into. You have the guy who's like, ooh, I'll be the rogue. You know, I'll be sneaky, stab people in the back and be like, ah, times 3 to my damage or whatever the fuck. Maybe you got like a sorcerer, a paladin, whatever the fuck. But then you got the guy who comes over and he's like, I think I'm gonna play a bard. Everybody at the table just looks at him like, why? Generally speaking, a bard is not a very popular class, and there's a reason that bards aren't very, there's not people fighting over, like, I want to be the guy with the fucking loot. People don't want to be the chronicler of your stupid adventure. They want to be the guy who's up at the front, choking Tarasque and fucking punching whatever that is, a pit fiend in the face, and breaking their nose through their back of their skull. A bard isn't really that kind of character, and it's not supposed to be. And not only is a bard not that character, a bard isn't really any kind of character. A bard is if you don't have a certain thing in your party, if you don't have a healer, a bard can kind of fill that role. If you don't have a wizard, a bard can kind of fill that role. If you don't have a thief, a bard can fill that role. A bard is a jack of all trades. A bard is a filler character for spaces that you didn't necessarily fill when you were making the party. He kind of patches up the holes here and there. He's like, you can do pretty much anything. The only hitch to that is that he's not really good. He's good. He's serviceably good at them. But he's not like an expert. He's not. A fighter's going to be a better fighter than a bard, even though a bard can be a fighter. A bard's not going to know as many spells as a wizard or a cleric. Basically, the only thing the bard does that is kind of like, I guess, unique onto the bard is that he can sing songs before you go into battle. He could bang on his lute and go like, we're going to kill some people, and then we're gonna go home and drink and fuck. All the people are like, yeah, drinking and fucking, I can't wait to do that. Let's go fight harder now because of drinking and fucking. Yeah, generally speaking, the bard isn't... He's kind of that character. It's like in 4th edition D&D, there's a class called a warlord class. And the warlord class is only defining feature is that it moves other characters on the board you know, it just kind of goes like it's a leader class. It's where basically it turns to one of the characters. It's like, you go over there, and basically he uses his turn to give them another turn, and then that's how he like moves people into position. That's it. He doesn't fight, and he doesn't heal, and he doesn't actively throw men. It just kind of feels like, why the fuck would I be this character? Essentially, the goal, like, the point of the, they're buffer classes. They're support classes. A bard is a support class. It's a better support class than the warlord, in my opinion, because at least it has shit that it can do. Besides telling other people what to do. That's his ability, is that he's just a really bossy guy. The bard has other things that are available to him, and they're cool things. Like, you can dabble in pretty much anything. You could be the face. You're probably the face of the party, because you need a pretty high charisma score in order to be a bard. Unless there's a paladin, then he kind of supersedes you. But still, you go around, you talk to people, you know. You get the party into places they probably wouldn't be able to get into normally. You can pick pockets and do all the stuff that a thief can do. And, of course, you get bardic knowledge, which is like a bar. It's supposed to be like a bard goes into a bar and hears a bunch of people talking. And he's just sitting there like, yeah, just kind of mind his own business. But what he's really doing is he's sponging up all the information around him. He just can't help but remember it. That's where bardic knowledge comes from. See, if you're an adventuring party and you're going across the plains, for example, you end up in the plain of Beator. And everybody's like, where the fuck are we? Because they have no idea where the fuck they are. And then the bard comes up and he's like, I know this place, it's Beator, I heard about it in like a fucking inn once. We start playing some songs to make us feel better. But that's a pretty useful character to have on hand when you're, especially for a party of people who is just like, who are just filled with, if there's a group that's predominantly like fighter-oriented people, and they come across like anything. It could be anything. They come across a thing that's sentient and alive. Their first instinct, probably, is to approach it, even if it looks evil or bad. Actually, that gives them more incentive to approach, because now it's a fight they're getting into, and they're just like, yeah, with their fucking swords and shit. And they're just like, this is gonna be awesome. But a lot of times when they approach things like that, it's dumb, because those things are really, really tough. And just because you're a third level fighter does not mean that you can just run anywhere and kick everybody's face in. Because that thing will fuck your shit up pretty hard. I mean, especially if that's what the DM put it there for, is for just idiot bait, for people to just be like, oh, look at it, I'm gonna kill it with my sword. But if a bard is there in the party, he could run up and be like, wait a second, guys. And they probably all hate him for this too, but wait a second, guys. That thing happens to be, and I know it because I have bardic knowledge, that thing is a pit fiend, and it's going to rip your dick off and shove it up your ass if you go over there. It's a don't do it. So, thanks, bard. That's good to know. I mean, some people will be like, oh, fuck you, you little piece of shit, I don't care. Just like, fuck you, bard, I'm going to take care of this. And then he just gets his dick ripped off and has it shoved up his ass. That's actually what the pit fiend does. Look it up. There's not many classes, there's not many other classes like that, in the sense that you look at, like, it doesn't seem useful at face value. It doesn't seem like a glorious class to play. Because essentially what a bard is a cheerleader for the... He's a cheerleader. He can do other things, but he's just, his defining trait is his the buffs that he just like plays a song and everybody gets real amped and they go out and get bonuses to fighting and shit and such shit. Also, they have the bardic knowledge. But other than that, they can cast spells, but so can other classes. They can pick pockets, but so can other classes. So it's like. They have skills, but all other classes have those skills. So if you have that particular class in your party, that aspect of the bard is pretty much nothing. It doesn't matter. But yeah, at least in AD&D and Pathfinder and stuff like that, that's really the only class that is just like has a very specific pigeonholed role, and if other classes are in the party, can easily just make him useless, other than the fact that he can sing songs and buff people and he has bardic knowledge. There's not really any other class that's maligned for being a set, quote unquote useless in the sense that It's just not a very unique skill set that the bard has. It has its moments where it's, you know, where it can be useful, but I mean it's very specific. It's that situation in Beator when a fucking fighter thinks that he can fight a pit fiend and the bard goes up to him and goes, "Actually, you probably shouldn't do that, you dumb motherfucker." But yeah, other than that, I mean, I would love to play a bard. I think I'm going to be playing in a next D&D next playtesting session or two, and I'm probably going to play a bard because why not? I want to play a bard. It seems like I could make a pretty fun guy. He's just like, maybe he's not a fighter, he's a lover, you know what I mean? I think I'm gonna play a bard just because it goes well for small parties. If you have a small party, like if you have like two or three people in your party, maybe even four. It's good to have a bard because then, like, not everybody, most likely you'll be without a wizard or a cleric. And maybe even a thief, so he can fill all those roles if need be. Of course, he's gonna get very tired very quickly of having to do everything that the two fighters can't do, or whatever, whoever the fuck is adventuring with him. But he'll be able to do it rather well. Okay, time's up, gotta go. Nice talking to you.
Still rockin' my crew with a bard and a thief. Still got love for the meats, reppin' D&D. Still, the feet hang, still running this thing. From third to fourth, ain't too much change.
I'm representing for the players all across the world.
Still,
killing kobolds with my claymore, girl.
Still, taking time to perfect the sheet. And I still got love for the feats. It's the D&D.
I'm representing for the players all across the world.
Still
killing kobolds with my claymore, girl. Still.